We have lessons for courses, and then lessons could have topics. Hi there, Danica here, and in this video, we are gonna continue with the LearnDash for Beginners series. And for this one, we are gonna dive in with the LearnDash lessons. Now, before we start checking what this section is for, I have a flowchart in here to explain the hierarchy of how the LearnDash works. So, as you can see in here, with LearnDash, we have different kind of post type. So we have the groups, which I could consider the highest of the level or tier. You could also consider this like membership levels, because you could also use it that way. So we have the groups, we have certificates, we have courses, we have challenge exam. Now, for courses, a courses could belong to a groups, and then certificates could be assigned to a courses or a course or a groups. So example, if you have some courses and you want to generate a certificate when the member or the enrolled user finish that, then you could assign a certificate, and then you could also have certificate for groups. For courses, they have this two lower post type that's assigned to it. So we have lessons for courses, and then lessons could have topics. Now, you can't create topics without lessons, so just a note on that one. And of course, we have some quizzes. Quizzes needs to have some questions, and then once the enrolled user has answered those questions correctly, then we could give out points. So this is just a simple flowchart, but do note that example, if you integrate LearnDash with other add-ons like Gaming Press, you could do more stuff with this one to gamify your members or users experience. So I hope this helps, and let's go back to our lessons page here. So LearnDash lessons belongs to a LearnDash course. So in this screen, as you can see, I have some example lessons here, and you can see on this column that there is a name assigned course. So you can see that this lesson is assigned to this one and other meta value as well, like author and creation date. On this page, we could also see the add new button, the blue one on the upper right side. And then on the actions, just like the courses, we could assign some lesson categories and lesson tags. Now on the settings, you can see here that we have, or by default that is enabled, but if you don't need that, like to save some space in your database, I suggest you disable this if it's not necessary in your setup. So just a note that you could disable that if you don't need it. Now you could also like add more like organization with your LearnDash lessons. And as you can see, we could also enable the post categories or post tags. So if you prepare that rather than having like a different categorization and tags for your LearnDash lessons, then I suggest you enable this rather than this to here. So again, depending on your setup, you could do whatever you need in this section. In the lower part, we have lessons custom post type options, and one of the options is to allow LearnDash lessons search. In here, you could enable this and, example, limit this to only login users or else enrolled users. So this helps, example, if you really want to protect your content, let only like login users can search if it's available, then you could set that up in here. So it acts like another protection level as well. So if you're not using like a membership plugin to protect your whole content, then you could take advantage of this one. But of course, other than the groups, which also acts as a membership protection plugin, or it works like that one. You could set it that like that one. So it also protects those content. So again, this is just another level of protection, and it specifically targets how like your member could search your lessons. Archive page, you could enable this if you want to. Like example, if I type this URL in here, And then I go lessons. It's gonna give me 404 because that was not enabled. Now if I enable this, so you can see it says archive URL is now your domain / lessons. And you could also enable some RSS in here. And of course at the bottom there's additional settings. Now let's just check this, how it works when it's enabled. Again, a note that we're not using any additional themes or page builder. In this tutorial, we're gonna focus on LearnDash only. So we are just using the default WordPress theme and its page builder, which is Gutenberg. If I refresh, as you can see, the lessons is now listed in this archive page. Again, depending on your setup, you may or may not need this. So you could turn on and off this section depending on your project. So that's what the lesson settings is and the actions that you can do on the upper right side. Now, let's just open one of the lessons and see how it looks. So this section is the title, and of course you could add some content in here. Once you click one of the blocks by default on the right side, Gutenberg will change what options you could do in terms of styling that block. For now, let's focus on the lessons tab. And as you can see here, we have some status. We have template. This is because the WordPress default template allows you to create template assigned to the single post now. So that's why it's available in there. And then we have permalinks, lesson categories, and so on, featured image, and so on in here. Now you could see on the associated content which course is this lesson is assigned to in which order as well. So you could see that we have practicing formal mindfulness in here, and you could also see that there is an assigned topic. And then if I open this, so it opens the course that that lesson was assigned to. Now I'm just gonna go back and I'm gonna open a new tab so that I could preview this course. I'm gonna manually give a points to myself for this purpose so that we could preview that. So LearnDash course info is available on the user's profile, and then there's here extra course points. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, and let's just try to take this course so that you could see how that lesson looks. So at the lower part we have the tables or course content, and the one that we just checked is this one. This is the LearnDash default format. So by default they have this left navigation, and then on the right side we have the content. Now going back on the lessons page, we have a settings in here just like the courses. So on the very first one we have the display and content options. In here you could enable and disable some stuff. By default these are disabled. Maybe in the future they're gonna add more items in here, but right now they have lessons, materials, video progression, assignment uploads, but also force timer for this lesson. So this is, it's this one, right? So example, if I enable this, and then let's just say I'm gonna do test. Just like the course materials, it should show in here. It says I need to complete the previous topic, so I'm just gonna quickly do that. I'm gonna manually mark this complete for now because I haven't set up those questions yet. So to do that, I'm gonna do details, and then I'm just gonna update this. So I should be able to access that lesson now. Okay, so after I completed this one manually, Then, as you can see, the material section is now on and I can see that content that I set in here. If I turn this off and then update and then refresh, you can see that it's also gone. So that's the material section for lessons. Now we also have a lessons access settings in here, and as you can see, you could see which course does that lesson also belongs to. So we could see it in the lessons page, and we could also see that data in here. You could also set this as a sample lesson. So the way that works is, example, if they are still thinking about enrolling their course and they want to see a glimpse of how you are or what you're teaching for that course. So you could set some sample lessons that those unenrolled users see or check or watch so that they could like understand what you're trying to offer. Other than, of course, the course info on, or maybe if you have the landing page for your course. But again, this having a sample lesson will also help just for them to get an idea how the flow works, what type of instructional format you offer. So sample lessons are very helpful for your courses. So you could turn that on. And again, they don't need to be enrolled to your course to get or to access this lesson. So just a note on that one. The lesson release schedule in here, we have three options. We have immediately, we have enrolled, enrollment-based. So it says lessons will be available X days after the course enrollment. So it's going to be based on the date of the course enrolled and then specific date. So in here, it says lessons will be available on a specific date. So the way, example, if I enroll today and then I set this to enrollment-based, and I say 7 days. So 7 days from my enrollment date of the course is when this lesson will be open for me. Until then, this lessons will be locked and I can't access it. So it's like a dynamic date behavior that you could take advantage. Specific date is, example, if you really have a strict date for that lesson, like you only want this to be available maybe on certain event that you are doing for that course, then you could take advantage on this one. So that's it for the LearnDash lessons. I hope this video helps. Again, your lesson must be part of a course when you're building it, so you need to think of it. Think of it this way, that your courses has a lessons and your lessons has topics that you could also assign. Now, it's not a requirement for lessons to have topics. It really depends on how you organize your course contents hierarchy. So if you need a lower or sub content for your lessons, then the topics will be very helpful. In the next video, we will be checking out the LearnDash topics. And if you have any question with the LearnDash lessons, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I could. And I really appreciate your support. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.